As new characters getting released, most people will start to ask, who should I pull? When should I pull? When do we get another compensation rewards? But no one asks about, how do I pull?
The prophecy is true.
Hey, what happened?
In most gacha games, you get these two options. Whether you want to pull one by one, or you can just go 10 at once and hope you won before reaching your max PP. Now, for the sake of this research, I willingly sacrifice a huge amount of my precious polychromes. Well, at least I won the 50-50, right? Yep, you might notice, in my previous video, my gacha went down the sink along with my F2P dreams and unnecessary amount of wasted polychromes.
What did it cost?
Everything.
But is there really nothing you can do to defeat this 50-50 system? What if I told you that you can? Fortunately, in Zenlesson Zero, you get to know how far you've gone, helping you calculate how much you've spent on said banner. And this is where things get interesting. Time out, we are about to unveil a forbidden knowledge where all math haters won't be able to handle. So if you want to skip all the maths and numbers, you can go to this timestamp instead. Okay, back to the video. According to my experience, research, on my account where I go for 10 pulls at a time for 90 pulls, I got a total of 13 A ranks and 2 S ranks, with an average of 1.7 A plus rank per 10 pulls. Meanwhile, on Jelly Emote's account, she got a total of 12 A ranks, 2 S ranks, and an average of 1.6 A plus rank per 10 pulls. Okay, with this alone isn't enough because luck surely holds a significant role in gacha, so I did another pull, and I got a total of 24 A ranks and 3 S ranks in 180 pulls, including the previous 90, while Jelly Emote got 26 A ranks and 3 total S ranks. Now, the moment of truth, is one pull really have much difference? Let's compare it. On my account, I got a total of 38 A ranks, 2 S ranks, with a total of 180 pulls. Meanwhile, on Jelly Emote's account, she got a total of 35 A ranks and 2 S ranks with the same amount of pulls. Okay, it looks like the 1 pull have a higher chance to get A plus rank compared to 10 pulls. But here's the thing. For some reason, both accounts got S ranks earlier when doing the 10 pulls, specifically on the 50 and 40 pulls on my account, and 10 pulls only on Jelly Emote's account. But let's just put that fun fact on It's All About Luck section instead. So what do you think? One pull surely gets you more A plus ranks from each 10 pulls, and you can stop after getting your desired rewards, saving you a chance to do more pulls on other banners. But it costs you a lot of time. On the other hand, 10 pulls is when you want to do pull spree and suddenly all your polychromes are gone to void with a bunch of S rank characters and weapon you don't ever use at all. You know what? Why should you pull? Why do you even need to pull? Why should you overthink which one should you do or who should you get? I know you can do it even without any pulls. Believe in yourself, because I believe in you. You don't need that banner. Heck, you don't even need anything. Just go level 1 Nicole, no teammates, no items, no upgrades, and show them how good you are. Now go out there and prove your godhood to the rest of the world. Flex how much polychrome you have, and tell them it's for decoration, because you don't need any of it. Don't be just let me solo her. Prove them you are the let me solo all.
So yeah, that's that. What do you think? Let me know in the comment.
See ya!